Hello children, how are you guys? Hope you're all fine and safe, and God have extended your life with long period and without any disease. Let's thank God for our good health. Okay, children, in the last video I remember giving the introduction about the conservation of plants and animals. Yes, and in this class, let's start up with the lesson. Okay, for the conservation of plant and animals, like what is the reason we should go for this step? Why we have to conserve means there are so many reasons. So to begin with, it is deforestation. D means remove. Removal of forest, that is cutting down of trees. Okay, and cutting, removing the number of living beings in the forest leads to deforestation. Okay, see, there are large varieties of plants and animals are seen in the forest area. Okay, maybe like, you know, when you go home, you might have come through the forest, or when you go for any hill station or to your native place, on the way you might have come through the forest. And if you closely observe, you'll find so many varieties of animals. Okay, and I don't know how many of you have traveled via Krishnagiri, Dharmapuri, Hosur to Bangalore. I don't know how many of you have gone through this. In this area, it is like full of forest. Maybe it is small cities are there in the middle. Okay, after Mettur, it is Mecheri, then Tuppur, then it will be, you know, Dharmapuri, after that Krishnagiri, and after that Hosur. In between these places, maybe there are small villages, and in between the villages, you will find, you know, beautiful greeneries, forest. Okay, so what we do means, like if you closely observe that, you will be able to find lot of living beings, lot of plants, variety of plants will be able to observe. But we human being, for our well-being, okay, and since we have to survive, what we do, we kill the living organism in that area. It may be plant or the animal. Cutting down of plants, it is killing them. We are killing a living being there. Okay, so it is a threat for the survival of the living being in the forest area, is called as deforestation. Okay, we clear off the forest and use that land for our purpose. Yes or no? I remember telling, you know, like few children were there in my live class last time. I was telling them, you know, the area where I'm living now, it was, you know, ages back, it was Mandop. Lot of mango trees were there, it seems. And that too, it belongs to one of our parent. Okay, and then that parent met me on the way, and she was telling me, she asked me where you are living, and when I said, she said it was an area where it was like only mangoes were there, and now there are 92 houses and ours is the 92nd house. Hundreds, you know, the land, hundreds of trees were destroyed. This is called as deforestation. For what? For our well-being. Okay, and children, the trees are cut for the purpose of procuring land for cultivation, okay, building house and factories, okay, and then making furniture or using wood as fuel. Okay, like we know now, as soon as if a tree falls, what happens? The people living by nearby, they go cut the tree and bring, because they'll be using it as firewood. Okay, and in Bangalore and all, you can find, you know, the buildings which reaches the sky. It is like around 20 floor building or a 30 floor building. It will be like so tall buildings are there, like apartments are there. Okay, so they build it as buildings and, they build houses and factories. Okay, and they destroy the forest and they'll convert it into the land for cultivation. Of course, if it is cultivation, it is one way, it's good, but for building and factories and using it as like firewood and furniture, it's not that good. Okay, so these are all This is called as deforestation. And if deforestation extends, what is the consequences? Okay, what is the result of it? That's what we are going to read. Okay, the first one is our temperature will increase. Okay, the temperature of our earth gets increased because of deforestation, and also the pollution level will increase. There will be increase in the temperature and also pollution level of our earth. Okay, then if there is no tree, naturally, if there is no plant, naturally the level of carbon dioxide will be more. Okay, and the groundwater level, since we build so many thousands and thousands and thousands of houses, the groundwater, we are draining it, so the level of groundwater will decrease. Okay, and it disturbs the balance of nature. Okay, the biological food chain will disturb, the biological pyramid will disturb. So the biological level, the nature of the biology balance will get disturbed. Okay, and if these deforestation keeps continuing, there will be reduction in the rainfall. Okay, and when there is reduction in the rainfall, what happens? It leads to dryness. So this leads to desertification. Okay, and the fertility of the soil also will get decreased. Okay, and there will be lot of natural calamities like flood and drought. Okay, there will be a flood in the area if there is no trees. Okay, there will be soil erosion. Okay, and there won't be enough photosynthesis, because of which we may not be able to get our food. Okay, and the amount of carbon dioxide in our earth will increase, which leads to pollution, and it leads to, on the other side, global warming. When the temperature increases, it leads to global warming. When carbon dioxide increases, that also leads to global warming. Why? Because of deforestation, since the photosynthesis haven't taken place. Okay, and if the temperature of the earth increases and if it disturbs the water cycle, it leads to decrease in the rainfall. Increase in temperature, okay, leads to disturb in the water cycle, and it reduces the rainfall, which leads in drought. Okay, and the major cause of deforestation is the change in soil properties. Okay, the physical property of the soil. Soil, it is like, you know, salty in nature. It is acidic in nature. Okay, so when there is no rain, the acidity of the soil will get changed. The physical property and the chemical property of the soil will get changed, because of which we may not be able to go for plantation or vegetation. Okay, and it may lead to soil erosion also. That's what is going on in hill station nowadays. Like, you know, last week you might have seen in the TV, there is soil erosion in Ooty, there is soil erosion in Munnar, there is soil erosion in Gudlur. Okay, wherever there's hill station in Kerala, there is soil erosion. What is that? What is the reason for that? The reason is the deforestation. Okay. And the fewer trees, whichever is there, they may not be able to hold the soil properly, because of which the soil will be washed off with the rainwater. The topmost soil will be washed. So if the topmost soil is washed, what will be there in the next layer? It will be only the rocks. Rocky land will not be, we cannot use it for the cultivation. Okay, so the soil will become less in humus. Humus means the liquid part of the soil is called as humus. Okay, so the humus will be reduced, and because of which there will be less fertile. Okay, and when there is no fertility in the soil, it leads to desertification. Okay, so the side effects of deforestation is drought and also desertification, landsliding, okay, loss of soil fertility. All these are the result of deforestation. Is that clear, children? Okay, bye.